guys, today I'm going to be doing another makeup look. You guys have been requesting makeup looks, so I'm trying my best to produce them for you. Today, this look will be kind of, I guess you can say, wild. I have been really into the bold makeup lately, so I decided to create some craziness and film it for you guys. So, if you're interested in seeing this look, make sure you stay tuned. First, I'm going to start off by priming my eyes with my MAC Painterly Paint Pot. And you want to apply that all over the lids. And make sure that you blend it out as well. Then I'm going to be taking my Urban Decay Vice Limited palette. I believe that's which one that is. If not, make sure you check down below in the description box for the products. And I'm going to be using that pink shade. I will have the exact shade in the description box as well. I'm going to apply that to my crease area. I think that's my crease, as a transition color. Then I'm going to be going in with my Sleek makeup palette. I'm not sure which palette that is. I don't have my makeup on hand right now. But like I said, everything will be in the description box. And I'm going to apply that to the same area. These are two different color pinks. This one is a softer pink. Then I'm going to take the purple shade and I'm going to apply that on top to deepen the crease area. Then I'm going to go back into that same Sleek palette and I'm going to use the deepest purple there is and I'm going to apply that directly in my crease. It kind of plays like a cut crease, but it's really not, I don't think. But it definitely defines the crease. Then I'm going to go back in with that same Sleek palette, the light purple and the light pink shade, and I'm going to go on top of my transition color again just to blend that the harsh edges out from the deep purple. Then I'm just going to take a regular MAC blending brush and blend out the harsh edges again, kind of try to smooth everything out. Then I'm going to take my Painterly paint pot again and I'm going to apply that right on top of my lids. Kind of curve out, or carve out the shape that I want to achieve so I can get ready to apply the other shade. So now I'm going to be using my new Urban Decay Moondust palette. I freaking love it. It's like so amazing. And I'm going to take the shade, I think that's Light Year. It's that green, like the green turquoise like color. And I'm going to apply that to my lids. And these eyeshadows are like way easier to apply with the brush that I'm using right now or with your fingertips because they have like glitter in them and it's really really hard to kind of apply it with certain brushes. So like I said, with this brush or your fingertips and you should be fine. So I'm going to go back in with the Sleek makeup palette, taking that deep purple, and I'm going to go back and apply it to my crease. Then I'm going to go in with the Urban Decay Vice Limited palette, and I'm going to take that gold color and I'm going to pop it right in my inner tear ducts. That's for now. And then, as you can see, I had a brilliant idea to take my MAC palette. Well, it's not even a full palette, but take the green shade. I have to check to see which color that is and pop it inside of my inner tear ducts. I really like the way this came out, better than the gold. And then I'm just taking my MAC brush and blending out the harsh edges, you guys. So next I'm going to be taking my Tardeus eyeliner. It's a double-ended eyeliner. One side is liquid, one side is like a gel crayon. And you guys, like, I suck at wing liner. So what you see here is I actually wiped some off and started over. So that's what you're seeing. That's why, like, my eyelid is already like halfway done. I just need to do the wing. Yeah, because I suck at it. So I had to like try to fix it off camera. But I really like the Tarte eyeliner. It's like definitely pigmented. So once again, I'm going back in with my MAC Painterly Paint Pot, and I'm going to apply a little bit to the bottom lid so I can get ready to apply some color to the bottom lid. So I'm going to be taking that light pink and that light purple shade from the Sleek Makeup Palette. And that's what I'm going to apply to my bottom lid. And you also want to blend that out. So now I'm going to take the Tarte Tarte eyeliner and apply it to the waterline. Then I'm going to be taking my Maybelline Lash Sensational mascara. I freaking love this mascara. Like, that's my go-to mascara now. I didn't know how amazing it was, but OMG, like, it's so bomb. So that's what I'm going to be applying to my eyelashes. Then I'm going to be taking some Beauty Supply Store eyelash glue and some Vegas May eyelashes. I think it's the glamour one. And I'm going to apply those off camera. Then I'm going to go back in with my mascara and apply it to my bottom lids. Well, my bottom lashes. So I'm going to be priming my face with my Benefit the Professional, the matte control kind. It's like the newer one. It's like a gel. I think that's the newer one. And I'm going to be moisturizing my face with my Black Opal Even True and my Peter Thomas Roth 24 karat gold, I don't know what that is, face cream. Yeah. And I do have a review coming up for out of three of those products. And the foundation that I will be using is the L'Oreal Infallible Pro Glow. This is the new foundation from L'Oreal, and so far, I really do like it. And you just want to buff that into your skin. And also, if the first layer is not enough coverage, you can always go back in and add a second layer. So clearly I forgot to add my brow bone highlight, so I'm going back in with my MAC 3-dimensional eyeshadow. I can't remember the shade, but like I said, check the description box. And you want to make sure that you blend that as well. So next I'm going to go in with my LA Girl Pro Concealer in the shade Fawn and apply that to my under eye and the bridge of my nose so I can highlight my face. I'm going to take some Fix Plus by MAC, my MAC sponge, and I'm going to blend that concealer out. You definitely want to tap and not drag, if that makes sense. Tapping in makes it last longer and doesn't look patchy versus dragging it. And then I flip my sponge and I kind of like buff out the ends or the edges. Then I'm going to be taking this mixture that I created. It's the Laura Mercier translucent powder and my Ben Nye banana powder. And I just mix it together and I really, really like the way it sets my highlight. Then I'm going to be going in with my Black Radiance face powders in the shade Rich Mahogany and Mocha, I believe. And I just use the darker one right in the cheekbone area, and then I kind of like blend it out with the lighter shade. The hollows of my cheeks, not the cheekbone. I could not remember what it was called. And I'm also gonna apply it to my nose and my forehead as well. You wanna make sure you blend that contour into your hairline also. Then I'm just taking a regular brush and brushing off the powder that I used to set my highlight. Then I'm going to be going in with my MAC powder. It's the mineralized skin finish, but it's the loose powder. I really, really like that one better for some reason. I don't know why, but I like that one better. So that's what I'll be using. And I use it just to like set my whole face and kind of bring the whole look together so I won't look so ghostly, I guess. Then I'm going to be going in with the Becca Jaclyn Hill palette. I'm not sure what kind of palette this is. If you guys follow me on Snapchat, you know how I found this. But it has like 2 or 3 highlight shades and blushes in it, so that's what I'll be using today. And I'm going to be using two of the lightest highlighter shades. I know for a fact one of them is Champagne Pop. Then I'm going to take my MAC blush palette, and I'm going to use not the darkest shade, but I don't know. I think that's Raisin. I'm not sure, but like I said, check the description box for every exact product detail. And I'm just going to apply that to the apples of my cheek and blend it out into the contour. Then I'm going to be taking my NYX Liquids eyeliner and just fill in my mole because it got covered with my foundation. Well, both of my moles. Then I'm going to go back in with my mascara and go over my bottom lashes one more time. Then I'm just taking a regular baby lips just so I can moisturize my lips before I apply my lipstick. Then I'm going to line my lip with MAC Chestnut Lip Pencil. It's just a regular deep brown because I'm going to be applying a nude lip, and you guys know you need to line your lips if you're going to wear nude and you're my skin tone. So I'm going in with my Colored Rain Liquid Lipstick, and that's the first one that I'm going to use. And I'm just applying all over my lips. It wasn't the nude that I wanted, so like I said, I'm going to go in with another one, and you guys will see that in a second. So now I'm going in with a lighter nude, and I believe that's the called Marshmallow, and I kind of apply it right in the center a little bit and just blend it out so it's kind of like a highlight to the lips. And you just blot your lips until it blends. And I'm going to go back into that Becca palette, Jaclyn Hill, and take that highlight and just apply it to my Cupid's bow so it can make my lips appear a little bit more powdier. And then I'm going to set my face with my Fix Plus and my Skindinavia finishing spray. And I'm going to take that freaking bonnet off and let my hair do the talking and the makeup do the walking, baby. And here you have it. This is the finished look, you guys. Something very, very bold. You know, summer is almost to an end, so I decided to do something super, super funky, and I hope you guys enjoy it.